In this vlog, we will try to see a simple state management tutorial. So we will be considering a provider. So now let's add the provider in your dependencies. So here you can see this is a provider package. So you can just copy this and add this to our dependencies. So I have already added here. So now let's get started with this particular example. So with the help of a provider, you can expose the data and you can listen to the data throughout your project by making the provider the root widget. So now let us see a simple example. Let's import the material.dart and also provider. Dot which we have just added provider, right? So by using which we can import this provider dot. So now consider void main, and here we will be declaring class my app. So now let's create the class my app, which is a stateless widget. And now we are trying to use provider in our example here. So we need to make the root widget to be a provider. So I am considering change notifier provider here, and inside create consider context. And now let us try to return data. So what is data? So this particular data you are trying to use in this example. So the data is simple value. Let's create a class data.dart, and inside which we will be providing a class data which extends change notifier. So for making use of provider, you need to have this class data which is extending change notifier. So here I am considering a method value of type string. So here we will be returning a simple text value. Let's consider I am providing just my name here. So I am trying to return a string value when you try to call this particular method. So now here import data.dart here, and thereafter try to provide a child widget here. So we will be considering a material app, and inside which we will be providing a scaffold so that we will be also having an app bar here. So add a comma here. So app bar, and here inside the app bar title provide some text. Let's provide it as a provider. So I'm providing the text to be provider, and just try to adjust the code. And now let's also provide a body. So inside the body I just want to provide a text field, and using the text field we will be trying to populate this particular data. So here we are exposing some data here, and that particular data with the help of provider we are listening and trying to print it onto the screen using a text widget. Let us consider a consumer widget, and this is of the type data. Provide a builder, and here inside it provide the context, and also here I am providing a value data by using which we can read the data. Return a text widget here. Why text widget? Because we are trying to populate the data which we have exposed here using a data class which is extending change notifier. So inside the text let's make use of this data and try to fetch the value, which is nothing but the method which we have declared inside the data class. So now let's try to run the code and see the output here. So yes, we got our name printed onto the screen, but it's in the top left. So let's add a center widget and try to refresh the screen, and yes, we got our name printed onto our screen here. So with the help of a provider, we have just printed our name, and now let's try to refresh the screen, and you can see Flutter is also printed onto the screen, and you can just cut this consumer here, and inside the second .dart file, I want to move the code to the another screen so that it looks much easier. So here let's consider a class second, and here we can just add the consumer data, and also you need to import provider here, so that, and also data, just import the data. And now you may get a doubt why I have moved the code to the another screen here. Why? Because in your app you might be having different screens. Actually, this is not a screen also, it's a class just we have created, and it's the same single screen, but I just want to show you that in multiple screens, in your real-time example, when you are having 10 screens in your application, so when you provide the change notifier provider in the root widget, so here you can see this is a root widget here. So throughout your application, you can just make use of the data by just making use of the data.value, which is the provider object which we have considered. So it's this simple. I just want to make it easy for you to understand, so I just consider this easy example, and in our coming tutorials we will be seeing some more examples on the provider. And also here we have just used a single provider here, but you can also have multiple providers. So by using the multiple provider, you can provide the multiple providers and you can use them throughout your application. So these things we will be seeing in our coming tutorials, and the code for this tutorial is provided in the description section below. And if you are having any queries, do let me know in the comment section below. And yes, this is it for this tutorial, and if you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.